Why did God create humans if he knew they were going to sin? Why did God create Lucifer? Well, when God created Lucifer, Lucifer was an angel who was given the responsibility of mediating worship from earth to heaven. Now, let me explain that the Bible tells us that when God created the heavens, that they were dark and void, and there was no life. Doesn't sound like something God would create. The next verse we read, God said, "Let there be light." I want to suggest to you that there was light before the darkness. There was darkness before the light. There was evil in the world before the world was created. I always like to put it this way. What did God do with his time before there was time? Before he created the sun and the moon to separate the sky, the firmament? What did God do with his time before we had a 24-hour clock? Before the first day was ever created? We read about creation in Genesis. That, by the way, is why Genesis is always under severe attack, because it takes us back to the origin of God, the origin of evil. God has no origin. But what did he do with himself before he created us, before he created the angels, which included Lucifer? And when he comes and destroys the heavens and the earth and creates a new heaven and a new earth, what will he do with his time when time is no more? God pre-existed before there was the first hour on the clock, before the first human was ever created. Now, when God planted Adam and Eve into the garden, all of a sudden on the pages of Scripture, something appears. We don't know where it came from. It says that God told Adam, "You may eat of every tree in the garden." There was no garden before. God created a garden. He put all kinds of trees in there. That's why he said, "You may eat of every tree, but don't eat of that one, the tree of the knowledge of good and evil." Where'd that come from? Where did a tree with evil come from? Where did eating fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil ever come from? When did it appear? When did God make it? I suggest to you, evil existed far beyond and way before God ever created anything. Before he created the first man, before he created Lucifer, evil existed. Now, what does the Bible tell us about that? Ready? Nothing. Zero. We have no information that I know of in Scripture as to where evil started. We know that it was in that tree that evil would be created, the evil would be revealed the moment Adam and Eve ate of that forbidden fruit. But where did that evil tree come from? Where was it before all of this happened? Where was it before the silence of Adam and the sin of Eve? Where was it before the fall? We don't know. Because we don't know doesn't mean it didn't exist, and doesn't mean there isn't a good explanation. Now, I'm going to give you my theories. And I know you're not interested in theories. You're only interested in Scripture. What does the Scripture tell us we're going to do when we die or when Christ puts an end to time? What are we going to do? Well, I know one thing I don't want to do is pluck grapes and have angels fan me. That's not what I view heaven to be. Jesus gives us some clues. He says, you have been faithful over a little. Well done, good and faithful servant. You've been faithful over a little. Now, when time is no more, I will make you ruler over much. What are we ruling? What are we ruling? When the Great Commission was given, Jesus told his disciples, go into all the world, preach the gospel, baptizing them in the name of the Father, teaching them all that I have taught you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end or beyond the end of time. What are we doing? What are we ruling? Why are the angels, the Bible tells us, going to serve us? What is he going to make us ruler over? And when he tells us to go into all the world, why does he use the word cosmos? Go into all the cosmos. That's not just the world that we can see. That's not just the stars in the heavens. That's beyond that. The universe is beyond that. We will rule. We will preach the gospel. Why? Was this done before Adam and Eve were birthed by the hand of God? Does this mean that there was work to do, universes to conquer before the world began, before the world as we know it began? These are deep, deep questions. And the answers to those questions our finite minds cannot comprehend. That's why there's nothing in the scriptures that tell us where Lucifer came from, except that he came as a created being by the hand of God. But where did his evil come from? Where did the evil intents of his heart come from? Why did God create humans knowing that evil existed before we were even born? And why did God place the knowledge of that evil into that one tree? Why couldn't he just leave it alone? Why did he do that? Well, one reason is we would never know salvation. We would never know his great love. We would never know why he came to die on the cross. Today, there's a great debate in our world about the presence of evil. Politicians are afraid to use the word. They don't want to speak of another politician as evil or another political entomology as evil. They don't like to use the word evil in reference to the dialogue of an evil politician. We have a lot of trouble defining evil. But where did it come from? I maintain that it existed before creation ever occurred. And that it will exist even after you and I go to heaven, where there is no evil. But there are worlds to hear the message of Jesus Christ. To some who are extreme literalists of every portion of the scripture, that statement is kind of heretical, and I don't mean it to be. I said earlier, it's a theory that evil existed even before time began, and evil will exist even after Satan is cast into his prison. Because the presence of evil means the forgiveness that comes from the cross. Hope this helps.
Hello, my name is Danielle Cantler, team member here at MARKINC Ministries. Thank you so much for your continued support of this video series. Ask Dr. Betters is not meant to be a substitute for professional counseling, but instead is designed to extract the biblical principles around the questions being asked. We encourage you to seek professional counseling if needed. Professional counselors are ready to assist you at Anchored Hope Biblical Counseling. See the links below for more information on Anchored Hope and all of the free resources we offer here at MARKINC Ministries. Thank you for watching and welcome to the MARKINC Family.